It seems that more and more people are looking for ways to not have to deal with XAML when building a .NET MAUI application. And with this framework, MauiReactor, you can do absolutely that. You can use MVU build on top of .NET MAUI. Let's go check it out. On my channel, I've been showing you already a couple of different ways how to build your .NET MAUI apps with code and not XAML. We have the C# for markup extensions, which is in the community toolkit right now. Check out the video for that. I've already talked about Comet, which is also an MVU experiment that we've got going on from the official .NET MAUI team. But now there is the MauiReactor, which is built by Adolfo. I'm not even gonna try and pronounce his full name. He's from Italy and he's been building the MauiReactor. He's also done the version for Xamarin Forms. I think it's called Reactive UI or something like that. But now there is a MauiReactor, which is a MVU framework built on top of MAUI, which is really exciting. I've been looking into it for a little bit. I've been seeing tweets all over the place from Ado. We can call him Ado as well, not to confuse with Ado.net. And he's been tweeting about it as well with all kinds of crazy examples that he has on his GitHub repository as well. So actually, let's switch to his GitHub repository first. So this is where you can find all the information. Ado space from Italy. He doesn't have the sponsorship enabled. So Ado, Adolfo, if you're watching this, enable the sponsorships on your account because I want to sponsor you. I want to support you for this amazing work. And of course, as long as we can sponsor him, make sure that you start a repository, which is also a sign of you supporting this project. But for the rest, you can scroll down here. You can see what it is. He even has like some documentation, which is a work in progress. It's all open source. So if you love this, please consider helping Adolfo out as well. And a bunch of instructions that I'm going to walk you through here as well. And you can go through the samples that are here, the source that is here, so you can go check this out. Definitely do. Now let's open up a console window. So let's close this browser window right here. And I have this console window. And the first thing that we want to do is install the templates that are available for this amazing project. So what you want to do, I'm going to actually copy it here from off screen, the command, so that I don't have to type it here. .NET new install. And I think this command comes from the official page. I think we want to do not --- install, but just install, because the other one is being deprecated. So .NET new install reactor.maui.templatepack. And whenever we do, it's going to install it. And you can use it from the command line or you can use it from Visual Studio if that's what you want. You can use this short name to do .NET new MAUI reactor startup, create your project that way. But I'm going to do it through Visual Studio. Now, the other thing that I'm going to do is install a global tool, .NET global tool, to enable hot reload, because hot reload is enabled for this project as well by a custom tool that is built by Adolfo as well. So .NET tool install -g for global reactor.maui.hotreload. Just enter that and it will install this little tool for us as well, which we'll be using in a little bit. Now we've got that in place. Let's just open up Visual Studio. I'm going to do that in the presentation mode so that the fonts are nice and big and you can see everything just fine. And I'm going to create a new project right here. And whenever we do, we're going to see this new project type, which is the MAUI reactor templates. Here you can see it, MAUI Reactor based app by Adolfo Marinucci. See, there we go. I still tried to pronounce your name. So we have this one. And let's do next. We don't have any exciting options here. Project one. So let's call this MAUI Reactor sample, something like that. MAUI Reactor getting started sample, something like that. Maybe I'm going to do more videos about this. If you want to see more videos about getting started with the MAUI Reactor, let me know down in the comments. And I'm going to click create. And then it's going to create this new project type. And I can run this MAUI Reactor app. So here we go. Let me maximize this window right here. And we get this getting started with .NET MAUI, which is totally useless for this project type. For other things, it's very useful. Amazing new things here that you can go into the documentation, but for the MAUI Reactor, it's not going to link us to the right documentation for that. And let's have a look here at the Solution Explorer. We see a couple of new things, but also a couple of familiar things. So we see the MAUI program, and if we dive straight into that, that's our entry point for this MAUI application. You can see we have create MAUI app create builder, but here we can see the use MAUI Reactor app. So that's something new, right? That is something that Ado has built for us. It has like a couple of other things here. If debug, enable MauiReactor hot reload. But for the rest, it looks like pretty familiar, right? But we don't have XAML. So now he's doing this add resource. He's doing, well, he's still adding XAML for the styles and the colors here. But that's about it, right? Otherwise, we're not doing XAML. So we have to add this through these lines of code. Everything you can do in XAML, you can also do in C#. So we've got that. And the other things is, of course, like we have our platform, so we can still write our platform specific code. All the metadata for your apps is there. We have the resources. We have a global usings. I'm actually not sure if that's in the default .NET MAUI templates. You can definitely add it and use it like this as well, but we have it here for the MauiReactor templates. And here under pages, this is new, we have our mainpage.cs. And this is the equivalent of the main page in .NET MAUI, right? Where we have all XAML with the waving .NET bot. Now we have the same thing, but built with MauiReactor. Now, while I'm walking you through this, actually, let me deploy this to the Android emulator so that it's running in the background and we're not stuck waiting for that if I'm going to show you that. So let's just do that while I'm talking here. And you can see a couple of things. So MVU, if we dive into that a little bit, you know that that's all about state, right? We update the state and then that gets pushed to the UI, right? So that's how that kind of works. And here we have that main page state, in this case with the counter, because we have that counter clicked button. So we have that. And here our main page is actually a component which has this state object, right? So everything is built with states, which you might know, or components, sorry, which you might know more from React.js, or I think Flutter takes the same approach as well. So we have all these components that we're inheriting from, and we can specify the state object here, which will be used for the state of this actual page, which is actually a component. Are you still following? So we have all that. And here we have the override for the visual node, which is render. So whenever a page, whenever a component has to be rendered, it will call this render thing and it will render that on the UI. And that's kind of like how that MVU thing works, right? So on the render, we're going to return this new content page with a new scroll view, with a new vertical stack layout, which is all stuff that you know from .NET MAUI, right? And Adolfo has added his own kind of implementation, his own layer on top of the MAUI core bits here, but it's still MAUI components and it still renders to the native components as they should show up on that platform, right? And for the rest, he's trying to mimic here like the vertical stack layout, so a new image, the new label, welcome. Well, he changed the text here a little bit, obviously. Welcome to MauiReactor and the new button with this little counter thing, right? So we're going to say counter state.counter because we know this state object, right? Which is going to be placed in a state property, apparently, which is probably a part of this component right here. And we know it's of the type main page state because that's what we say here. We can do state.counter is 0, and it's going to say click me for the label, and else it's going to be clicked state.counter, so the amount of times that it's been clicked, right? And here we have this new kind of like MVU style syntax, right? So we have like this fluent syntax, the image height request, H center, so that's probably the horizontal center of things. And we just have a kind of like generic set where with which you can set like the bindable properties in this case. We also immediately get the support for the semantic properties, which is cool. So you can add that accessibility to your app here as well. So that is built right in accessibility for MauiReactor. Check, we got that. So you can see a couple of variations here, but for the button, we also have like this on click. So we also have the events here that you can totally do. So event on click set state, we're going to increment that counter and boom. We got some other things here for the vertical stack layout, some padding, some spacing. That's all how it works. And if we see this in Android, you can now see here, this looks exactly the same as you would do file new .NET MAUI application, but now with MVU style, and we have this same components. So that is really amazing. Now let's see if I can put this side by side a little bit here. Whoops, I want to have the emulator on the right side and Visual Studio on the left side. So let's see. I can make that happen here a little bit. Typically, I prepare these things so you don't have to watch me struggle with the UI here, but now I'm doing this live demo, just whipping up a MauiReactor project. Here we are. I can bring up a little terminal window here. So let's do, I think it's under view, and we can do terminal. And here, this opens in my project folder. And here I can start that hot reload. So you also have the hot reload things here for while you're actually running your debug. So I have to go into my change directory, MauiReactor folder here so that I get to the actual, you want to be in the CS proj here in the same folder as the CS proj that we have here. And then what you want to do, so let me, oh, I was gonna bring this up a little bit here. Then what you want to do is do .NET MAUI reactor dash F. So let me paste that in here. .NET MAUI, .NET dash MAUI dash reactor dash F. And then you want to specify like the TFM that you're running. So NET 7.0 Android. You can script this in Visual Studio to make this show up automatically. And I can press return here. So it's going to start setting up the build pipeline. It's going to inspect my thing. It's going to monitor my folder. And whenever I make a change, you can see monitoring folder. So whenever I make a change now, it's going to light up in my emulator. So let's do here. We also have like background. Background color. And if I just do the dot, you can see that we have all the APIs of .NET MAUI here. So we have border color, we have character spacing, we have clip, we have flow direction, we have everything that's inside of .NET MAUI. But now with this fluent syntax, MVU style, you can do all the things. And I want to do the background color, and you can just specify colors dot, I don't know, let's do yellow just so that it's crazy, you can see it. And whenever I save that, you can see that it's replacing the syntax tree and it's becoming here yellow in the emulator, right? So it shows up near real time. It takes a little bit of processing here, but it shows up here on the emulator inside of your running application. Of course, also works on all the other platforms that are supported. So that is really, really cool. Hot reload is in here as well. And for the rest, just go check it out for yourself. There's a couple of cool samples in the repository that I've just shown. And yeah, this is how you can get started with MAUI Reactor. Now, this is just your very high overview getting started with MAUI Reactor video, but I'd love to know in the comments, is this something that you like? Is this something that you would use? Adolfo put this out as a GA version. So, you know, you can use this inside of your applications. Applications are being built with this, which is really, really cool. Why do you like this over the C# markup extensions? Why do you like this over XAML? And do you want to see more videos about this on my channel? Basically, whatever your thoughts are, go inside of the comments and let me know. I try to get back to you, but I read them all, even if I don't respond. So definitely make sure to do that. Also, please don't forget to like this video, click that subscribe button, and maybe check out this video about the C# markup extensions that I've been mentioning a couple of times. And here is the playlist with other .NET MAUI videos. See you on the other side.